Hello, hello. It is Ryder, and today God wanted me to come online and share another prophetic word with you. And the title of this message is Increased Demonic Activity. Increased Demonic Activity. And if this message is for you, you are a child of the living God. You have repented of your sins and accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, believing that He has died on the cross to pay the price for all of your sins. And the Lord revealed to me in a vision last night, like before I was falling asleep, what is going on, like a bit of what's going on spiritually right now. So what the Lord showed me is I saw like all these like meteors like falling from the sky, and they were like hitting the earth. And out of the meteors, like, they would, like, split open, and out of them was coming these, like, creepy, dark, shadowy figures, you know, and they looked, demonic, you know, like, when God's revealed to me, like, a demonic presence or a demonic spirit, it looked just like that, and it reminded me of, you know, like, the story of how, like, you know, Satan was a fallen angel, you know, like, these beings, these entities, they were like cast out from the sky, they fell to the earth, and then the meteor cracked open, and then they were starting to prowl around the earth, you know, like they looked like they were getting ready to prowl around the earth, you know, like looking for victims. And, you know, God had told me, you know, like what's going on now is like there's going to be an increase in demonic activity, you know, like the devil, Satan, is using his army, you know, like he's bringing out more and more of his troops to the earth, you know, and this isn't just, you know, like to affect, like, you know, like the unbelievers, you know, to keep them from receiving the gospel. Like, the devil is also trying to attack the children of God, you know. So you might notice during this time an increase in spiritual warfare, you know. You might notice, you know, like more like ups and downs in your life. The enemy might be trying to use people around you to get to you. So if you have like a loose circle of people, you know, you don't trust everybody in your inner circle, or God tells you to remove someone from your life, it might be to just tighten up your inner circle and protect you, because not everyone, even not even everybody that professes that they love Jesus with their lips is actually a born-again believer. So God might be telling you to cut them off because they're a weak vessel, and because the devil has access to them because they still have willful sin in their life, and he can use them, you know, and we need to be on guard to keep ourselves from sin so that the enemy can't use us as well. But with that being said, you know, like, you might see an increase in spiritual warfare, or even just, like, these little annoyances that pop up, like, somebody, like, you know, cutting you in line, or, like, you know, trying to, like, you know, key your car, or, you know, like, you might, like, order something at a restaurant and they give you the wrong thing, you know, like these little things, you know, and, you know, the enemy is trying to get under your skin and get you out of character, you know. But God wanted me to come on, and he wants me to pray for you right now. And Father God, I just pray in Jesus' name that whoever this message is for, that they remember in the midst of the spiritual warfare that they have power and authority in your name to trample serpents and scorpions, that they have authority in the name of Jesus to bind and cast out wicked spirits, you know, that they know that whatever is loosed on earth is loosed in heaven, and whatever is bound on earth is bound in heaven. So I just ask, Father God, that you remind them of the power and the authority that they have, not because of anything that they've done, not because of who they are, but because they are a child of the living God, and because they are covered in the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And that's what God wanted me to come on and talk with you about today, is, you know, like, this power that we have as Christians. You know, we have power to apply the blood of Jesus. We have power to trample serpents and scorpions. You know, if you are a born-again believer, you have been filled with the Holy Spirit, then, you know, it's not just that you receive spiritual gifts, you know, like the ability to prophesy or speak in tongues or, you know, healing, miracles, like all these things. You know, you also receive authority in Jesus' name to bind and cast out wicked spirits. So yes, there might be more spiritual warfare going on, but you are a child of the living God, and you are equipped with everything that you need to deal with these wicked spirits. And this, I'm just hearing in my spirit deliverance. Like, this is a time, you know, not just for like delivering ourselves, you know, this is a time, you know, if you see the enemy like working through people around you, lay your hands on them, pray for them, deliver them from those wicked spirits. This is a time for deliverance because the enemy isn't really like holding back anything, you know, like it's very clear, like, you know, like the hand he's playing, like God is going to increase your discernment so you can see right through the enemy's tactics, see exactly like where these impure spirits are operating, who they're operating in, and you can deliver them with prayer. You can deliver them. The demons will flee if you rebuke them in Jesus' name, if you bind them up and cast them out in Jesus' name. And God wanted me to just bring to your attention as well, you know, it's actually like one of my favorite passages, you know, it's from Ephesians, and I remember making this video, like, when I first started posting on YouTube of me wearing, like, the costume, the night costume made out of balloon animals, and I'm, like, shadowboxing in my room, and the voiceover is this part of Ephesians, you know, like, it's Ephesians chapter 6 verses 10 to 18, and, you know, it's about putting on the full armor of God, and this is important with spiritual warfare. So this is the Apostle Paul writing to the church, you know, of the Ephesians, and he said, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions and on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. For this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God." And there were two things that stood out to me that God brought to my attention while I was reading this. You know, like he just made stand out to me. And the first is, you know, like our struggle isn't against flesh and blood. Like, yes, the unclean spirits operate in people, but we're not battling against the people. We're battling against the spirit that is in the person. So it's not like, you know, me against another person. It's the Spirit of God in me against the impure spirit that is in them. So everything is spiritual. We can't look at this with our earthly eyes. We need our spiritual eyes. And the next thing that God made stand out to me, you know, like, is the last line. It says, "And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people." Now more than ever, if there is going to be increased spiritual warfare, you need to stay prayed up. You need to find that time in prayer with the Lord every day. You need to be in the secret place, and do not be, you know, do not hesitate to lay your hands on somebody else and pray for them. Do not hesitate if God is, like, whispering to you to deliver somebody, you know, to lay your hands on them and to deliver them, to pray for them, to heal them, to bind up and cast out the wicked spirits that might be operating in them. So do not be afraid with this increase in spiritual warfare. Do not be afraid with the enemy sending out his army. Do not be afraid. God has given you power and authority, and you have been equipped with everything that you need through Jesus to withstand this test. With all that being said, for now, take care, stay safe, have a wonderful rest of the day, and know that Jesus loves you, and I love you too. Bye-bye.